so today I'm going to talk to you about effective communication and how communicating effectively can help your coaching and improve it. So first, we're just going to watch this quick video, but if you guys want to break up into a group of three and a group of two and go back on the whiteboard, while you watch the video, just think of a couple adjectives that can help improve this coaching session. So while we just watch this, just jot down a couple adjectives that could help improve his coaching.
Shut up. All right, I'm going to have a quick technique. I'll show you how to do it properly. Watch. All right, thank you.
And that obviously kind of showing a bad demonstration. If you watch the players one after that, she did what the coach did by missing it. But obviously he wanted them to score, so him not scoring, they didn't realize what they had to do.
Yep.
Yeah, that was sort of saying this communication impaired is less of aggressive looking and abrupt.
Mm-hmm.
A wee bit sort of angry.
Yeah. This group?
He's very dramatic.
Mm-hmm.
Aggressive.
Yeah. So I'm going to present to you guys, it's called the 7 C's. You guys can sit back down if you want. So I found these very beneficial when doing some research. The 7 C's that the article that I found very useful, they are completeness, conscientiousness, consideration, concreteness, clarity, comparison, and correctness. So after watching that video, can we link anything like to these that he could improve on, if that makes sense? I have some examples I'll show you guys, but if you guys can think of any.
Maybe the concreteness, because when he didn't even tell them that he wanted them to score, whereas if he just said, like, even if after we missed the goal, he might have said, maybe that was bad, but all I want you to do is just get through the corner and score.
Yep.
And then the players are like, oh, that's, then they kind of understand what they need to do.
Because he didn't really use any of these when coaching. So these are all things that he could easily improve on. So these are a couple that I thought. Clarity, he is not clear with what he wanted. He did part of the drill right, but then at the end he kind of just kicked the ball away rather than just scoring. Consideration, he seemed very impatient. He was very dramatic. He was throwing himself around whenever they kicked the ball, but that's in his demonstration that he did wrong. Completeness, the message of the demonstration wasn't complete, just like before. He did part of the drill right, like dribbling the ball through the cones, but then rather than just scoring the ball, he just kicked it to the side for some reason. Conscientiousness, there was a lot of little information, but the big picture wasn't really there. Concreteness, he was specific about the beginning part, but not the finish. Comparison, while doing the drill, the coach showed it, but the players really didn't have anything else to compare it to. And correctness, well, players didn't really do the drill right until the very end. Can you guys think of anything else of those seven?
Well, the players weren't very cooperative.
No.
So that would have an impact on how he's going to coach.
Yeah, but he could have easily taken the ball. Because
yeah.
At the one point, the kids were just playing with the ball. He could have easily just said, put the ball down. Anything else?
Didn't really ask for the feedback from the running student before this, you know, where you go.
This demonstration wasn't really, you know, well thought out. He hadn't really set it up correctly, and they were in one part, and then he moved me and he did it. They didn't even know he'd started the demonstration because they were running each other.
Yeah. Anything else? Good. All right, so now we're just going to do a little workshop. We're going to try and implement the seven C's that we just went over with this. I need one person to start, though. Does anybody want to be brave enough to start? All right, so you four, will you guys go stand in the hallway for me, please? Yeah. So you can start right here.
Yep.
So I'm going to show you a picture. And all you can do is just look at it. You can't draw anything.
Can I show them?
Yep. And then you're going to have to describe it to the next person that comes in.
Okay.
Okay? I'm going to give you a minute and a half.
Did I get to keep this?
No.
No. Oh. It's hard. It looks simple when you look at it, but then you're trying to remember. Think so.
Alright, I'm gonna, you can stay here. I'm gonna bring one more person in. Okay, I need one more. Just one person. Alright. He's gonna explain to you what he saw. You have about a minute.
Okay, so if you get your bit of paper out. Oh, have you cemented him or is it draw?
No, he can't draw it.
Okay, can't draw it? Okay, right. What we have is like an off-centered, an egg shape, can you imagine? Like a,
say off-centered, like a square?
Like an Easter egg square, circle, if you know what I mean.
Are you starting with a rectangular background, or does that
matter? No, this is it. It's all inside a circle, like an offside circle. So in the offside circle, I'm going to give you a couple of things. The middle would be almost like a three-tiered snowman, if you know what I mean. So
yes.
Body, middle, and bottom, right in the middle. If you're looking at it, at 2 o'clock is where you're looking at it. It'd be like a dartboard with a circle with two small circles inside it.
Okay.
So there's a circle.
Head effectively.
No. So one big circle. Okay.
One big sort of like
in the middle.
Eggs.
In the middle there's a small snowman.
Yeah. Three circles.
Uh-huh. Over here, still inside the large circle,
uh-huh.
There's three, almost like a dartboard, three smaller circles.
So okay. Three rings.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Inside the circle again, up here,
yep.
Is a triangle.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
At 12 o'clock.
At 12 o'clock, yep.
Uh-huh.
Then at about 8 o'clock, down here, there is a square
mm-hmm.
with a kite attached to it.
A square with like a kite?
Kite, so we've got like a diamond with a wee string.
Okay.
And then over here we've got an arrow.
Right, so it's four just things inside that, so.
So, let's go, I go one more time.
Ten more seconds.
We've got a large circle.
So sorry, what was this, an arrow, what?
An arrow.
Time set at?
4 o'clock, so.
4 o'clock.
2 o'clock dartboard, 4 o'clock arrow.
Mm-hmm.
8 o'clock square.
Yeah.
10 o'clock is, sorry, 12 o'clock is a triangle.
Mm-hmm.
In the middle there's a snowman.
Okay.
So dartboard, arrow, square of the kite, snowman in the middle, and a triangle at the top.
Alright, no more talking.
With a line going right through them.
Done. No more. Alright, hop on first.
That's a hard one.
Yep.
No.
Alright, so you can sit right there. David's gonna explain to you. You have to explain
okay,
to someone else.
So basically what we're talking about, the overall beginning shape, it's like an egg. Okay. Like an egg shape. So it's
oval.
Like an oval. Okay. Within that there's five distinct elements, shapes. So in the centre there's three circles. The way it was describing like a snowman. So three circles just all join in. So my impression of it's like a head, a body, and the bottom of it, okay? So three circles in the centre. At 2 o'clock, if you're looking at a clock face, well, we'll start at 12, okay? 12 is a triangle. Triangle, okay, so that's in the centre. Three circles all sort of joining.
Mm-hmm.
12 o'clock is a triangle. 2 o'clock, there's like a target. Okay, it's three circles, circle on the outside, circle inside, small circle inside. Okay. At 4 o'clock, go to this one over here, sorry, I think it's at 10 o'clock.
And 10 more seconds.
There's a kite, okay, so there's a kite diamond with a tail coming off it, okay. The whole thing has a line running through it.
Is it on top to bottom or is it on
the bottom? Yeah, diagonal from
yeah.
This way through.
There's an oval on the table, and inside the oval, right behind the middle, there's three circles, and they're lined up like a snowman, so three circles in a row. So if you think of the oval, at the top of the oval here, it's at 12 o'clock, okay, and then at 2 o'clock there is a triangle, and at 10 o'clock there is a rhombus shape, like a kite with a tail on it, and going from through that diagonal between the 10 and the 12, there's a straight line on the diagonal through it. So if you think of the oval, so the oval is at the tip of the oval, which is at its narrowest place, the narrowest place on the oval. It's 12 o'clock and 2 o'clock is the triangle. And the three circles in the middle have three joining lines joining up the three circles. And the line runs through the diagonal. 10 o'clock, between 10 o'clock and 12 o'clock.
Thank you.
Alright, so now I'm gonna show you guys the original picture.
That's it?
Do you guys think you guys are close? So what it is?
Well, if it's a snowman, we're as far as Christmas is.
Oh, okay. Quite far.
So some things got left off. Granted, this was a hard one, but thought I'd challenge you guys with it. What are things you could have done better?
Did
maybe
only the
get
first
the actual
person get to see the whole picture?
Yeah.
Yep. No one else did. You didn't get to see the full thing.
To be fair, I actually think Mark described it quite well to me.
Mm-hmm.
It was just my everybody else after me suffered because of the completeness of my
mm-hmm.
information. I left out a couple of things.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you're talking about information that was passed on, it was already started, it was inaccurate.
Yeah.
After, it's just, I found it hard to break down information.
I must have a few things to relate to,
the only thing I would say about the initial instruction, there was a couple of things maybe you didn't realise the time.
Mm-hmm.
Rushed at the end.
Yeah.
And the next effect that had, was interesting because to me that had the impact of what Joe was actually talking about in his.
Mm-hmm.
I actually forgot the initial things that were told to me because
the last thing I said was I remember.
Yeah.
Probably three of it then.
That was the only thing then I remember. And then after that, I was like, oh.
Yeah.
And then you were trying to, where I thought then that the object was to guess what he was telling me.
Mm-hmm.
So I was more focused on trying to work out what it was.
Yeah.
Because that's why I said, you said,
oh yeah.
Right.
So
rather than me take it, and then I said, oh no, hold on, I've got to listen more carefully.
Yeah.
And then
so you didn't know you were going to have to read.
No, tell it all. So I didn't know why I was going to pass a message on.
Because I didn't tell you guys.
No.
What it was.
No, I didn't know.
But
no.
Part of that is with effective communication, you have to be able to listen.
Yeah.
There's a lot of information.
Mm-hmm.
And he's probably passed on the key.
I struggled.
Mark did a good job.
Yeah, he did.
And if you look at the final picture, there's
you got
four elements out of
probably
eight.
Yeah, you got four out of the eight. Yeah, it's not bad.
But it was straight funny how people were adding on their own interpretation of it to someone else. What's bigger at this end or it's down here? And
mm-hmm.
that wasn't total, because I was here to hear it all.
Yeah.
There's bits of it where people weren't actually, hadn't mm-hmm. passed something on and people were interpreting it that way. You know, so.
But we can easily link this back to the seven seas, right? Because everyone does communicate differently.
So did you start with telling him everything that was on it?
No, I gave Mark the paper.
With the image on?
Yeah.
Okay.
And he was able to look at it and everything. But you can easily link the seven C's into this workshop exercise. Because completeness, throughout each person like explaining it, the completeness of the picture decreased. Straight to the point, it was hard for you guys to, I gave you all about a minute and a half, 2 minutes, but to explain this to every single person within that time frame is difficult and hard. Consideration, didn't really have to use the here. Concreteness, clear and specific. Are you telling them where it is, at what angle? Like, Mark used the time, 10-2, because it is like circles, so that was very good and easy. That's a comparison. You're able to use a clock to figure out where and what angle these things are used at. Correctness, information provided, obviously that trickled down as we went on. And clarity, was it effective? Well, a little bit. You got 4 out of 8, so that was pretty good. And then just to end with a little discussion, how do you think that you can improve your coaching through effective communication? And could the seven C's of effective communication improve your own coaching? So if you want to take a couple minutes to think about that, and then we'll have a discussion.
Yeah. that ends up, they forget that stuff, you might as well.
A lot slower,
yeah.
Maybe at the start, just
yeah.
So they've got time to actually process what I'm saying.
You're talking about the speed, but I think you have to know exactly what you're going to say.
Mm-hmm.
There can't be, because you know, any sort of hesitation and no one that the order affects how you take
yeah, it. Does.
You're like, what am I supposed to do? So if you don't give it like right away
yeah,
and know exactly what you're going to say and then you're going to say it, I think that's what you have to get to.
I agree. Okay, as soon as you kind of
for me would be what are the important things and what do I need to say and what can I leave out? Do I need to think about how they're going to react to what I'm saying? Yes, of course you do, because if I say the wrong thing, your sugar, for example,
yeah, yeah.
Up all the sugar, you're giving it off to her and she was back on the play because she's actually shooting very well. She's not really wanting to shoot any better. It's going to be on her head. So I think the order of how we speak to players and how we have empathy with them is all part of good communication.
Alright, so we'll bring it back together now and have a little discussion all together. Do you guys want to start with anything?
What I learned from it was just saying that if you were a group of coaches, we'd meet, we'll all get a message across to each other as a group. Because
mm-hmm.
if I was to pass on, can you tell someone else this? Can you tell someone else
yeah.
this? And then the next thing gets down, it gets muddled up. So for me, I think any kind of message we're trying to put in the coaching group and the club.
Yeah.
I think that was a group.
Mm-hmm. Anything from this group?
We're saying about the thing about that activity was there were no rules, so you didn't get a set of rules, right? Just listen.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But Joe and I are agreeing that when you're gonna say something that you've got it clear in your mind what you're gonna say and that it's at the speed that you say it at and how you deliver it
mm-hmm.
and that you have to think about the people around you, like because some players like you know, being
yeah.
motive and then others don't because then they get so it's all about how you're communicating that you have the right things to say and that the important things
mm-hmm.
aren't missed out.
Yeah.
Because I would say, have we had that no right? So I'm going to tell you something, you have to remember it.
Mm-hmm.
At the start, you're being more focused.
Yeah.
Whereas there's none, there's nobody telling you that. So you're trying to think, oh, this is a table or a table, but I think he's going to, but like, no, that picture art, no, that thing you draw.
Yeah.
Let me show you what it does.
Mm-hmm.
To me, that's what I thought it was.
Yeah.
Picture art, does it? And then,
yeah.
And I thought, oh, I would have to guess what he's, and I thought, it's just no man. Instead of just listening to what he was telling me, a nice,
yeah.
clear,
mm-hmm.
concise group of things, okay, that maybe I would have been drawing that image.
Mm-hmm.
It's about that. It's about self-imagery that we
mm-hmm.
have in sport training, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that I could really begin to formulate, which I've got a certain understanding of it. But look, you do it unconsciously, I think.
Mm-hmm. Anything else?
Sort of making the point as well. On a team talk, if something comes in your head and you think, oh, I haven't covered that,
mm-hmm.
the referee blows the whistle already at the start of the game. Is it important to upset the flow and the control of your team talk to throw something in at last minute?
Mm-hmm.
Because going back to the knowledge of the game, when Mark sort of it came to his mind and he said, I couldn't actually think of all the things that he told me.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So if he'd have just left that out, we'd have maybe missed out. But then I missed out, and confirming it's something else, I missed out a few. So I was wondering if that is actually possible. That's what happens to players in a scenario where if you rush them.
Because every player's different.
Last minute. They maybe, it could panic them, and they're going through the door, and the last thing they remember is just the thing that you sort of.
Said.
Yeah.
So it's like as well as that we thought the control Martin and Sex Bliss was very controlled, very, and that made me feel relaxed. So I like, okay, I can see, you know, whereas if to come back to what we were saying, if you sort of panicked, that can convey to the players, but it's all on how you deliver
the
control of it, you know, there's an instance where you're controlled and you're doing that effectively, the players could then feel like, okay, we know what he's talking about, we believe in his message. So.
Okay, good. So overall, you know, you saw the video with the bad coaching, you were able to come up with some adjectives that were able to improve his coaching, and we were also able to link that to the seven C's. It's actually kind of funny though to give a presentation on effective communication, because I have to be able to communicate effectively to you. And with the workshop I did in at the beginning, because I wanted to see how it would proceed, and I mean, with me not telling you guys any directions, you did get 4 out of 8, which is pretty good. Whereas I'm sure if I told you, you're gonna have to listen and then tell the next person what you saw, the drawing would have come out better. So the seven C's are just something to keep in mind while you're coaching, because they might seem simple, but to get that across to all your players can be difficult. So.